Good evening. On the day when still traumatized students in Newtown, Connecticut, return to school with their first Monday of the new year, this country is grappling with gun violence as never before. It's an issue you know I care passionately about. So here is my position, loud and clear. I'm in favor of a nationwide ban on military-style semi-automatic assault weapons and high-capacity magazines. I want to close the gun show loopholes and require private dealers to run background checks on buyers at gun shows. And I'd like to see the president increase federal funding for mental health treatment for all Americans who need it. I think these are entirely reasonable reactions to the outrages that have occurred in America over the last few months. But tonight, I'll go head-to-head with a man who actually wants to deport me for having these very views. And over 104,000 Americans apparently agree with him. That's coming up. Anyone who's watched this show over the past few weeks knows I've taken a pretty strong stand on guns in America. It's not escaped the notice of supporters of gun rights, and it's led to a petition on the White House official website, no less. It's entitled, and I quote, "Deport British citizen Piers Morgan for attacking Second Amendment." Take a look. More than 104,000 people have signed it so far. And joining me now is one of the people behind the petition, Alex Jones. He's host of the Alex Jones Show. Welcome to you.
Piers, thanks for having me.
Why do you want to deport me?
Well, we did it as a way to bring attention to the fact that we have all of these foreigners and the Russian government, the official Chinese government. Mao said political power goes out of the barrel of a gun. He killed about 80 million people because he's the only guy that had the guns. So we did it to point out that this is globalism and the mega banks that control the planet and brag that they've taken over in Bloomberg, AP, Reuters, you name it, brag that they're going to get our guns as well. They've taken everybody's guns but the Swiss and the American people. And when they get our guns, they can have their world tyranny. While the government buys 1.6 billion bullets, armored vehicles, tanks, helicopters, predator drones, armed, now in U.S. skies, being used to arrest people in North Dakota, the Second Amendment isn't there for duck hunting. It's there to protect us from tyrannical government and street thugs. Take the women in India. Your piece earlier on CNN I was watching during Anderson Cooper's show didn't tell you that the women of India have signed giant petitions to get firearms because the police can't and won't protect them. The answer wait a minute, I have FBI crime statistics that come out a year late, 2011. 20%+ crime drop in the last 9 years. Real violent crime because more guns means less crime. Britain took the guns 15, 16 years ago, tripling of your overall violent crime. True, we have a higher gun violence level, but overall mugging, stabbings, deaths, those men raped that woman in India to death with an iron rod 4 feet long. You can't ban the iron rods. The guns, the iron rods, Pierce, didn't do it. The tyrants did it. Hitler took the guns. Stalin took the guns. Mao took the guns. Fidel Castro took the guns. Hugo Chavez took the guns. And I'm here to tell you, 1776 will commence again if you try to take our firearms. Doesn't matter how many lemmings you get out there on the street begging for them to have their guns taken. We will not relinquish them. Do you understand? That's why you're going to fail, and the establishment knows, no matter how much propaganda, the Republic will rise again when you attempt to take our guns. My family in the Texas Revolution against Santa Anna, my family was at the core on both sides starting that because Santa Anna came to take the guns at Gonzales, Texas. Pierce? Don't try what your ancestors did before. Why don't you come to America? I'll take you out shooting. You can become an American and join the Republic.
You finished?
Yes, I am finished. You will not take my right. You go through background checks to get guns. How about Prozac? You know the number one, that's a big sponsor, isn't it? Or that whole class of drugs.
Let me ask you a question.
Got to cut that off, don't you? Don't want to talk about the U.S. number one cause of death is suicide now because they give people suicide mass murder pills.
Calm down.
Your answer is give more money to the psychiatrist and psychologist to put more crazy people on drugs that make them kill people, Pierce.
Let's try and have a debate here.
Yeah.
Answer me this question.
I'm sick of the same old script here, bud.
It's fine, bud. How many gun murders were there in America last year? Do you know?
There were about 11,458, and about 74% of those were gang-related, gangbangers shooting each other. You get 3,500 to 4,000.
Okay, that wasn't the
case. How many people died from infections in hospitals? 197,000.
Let me just ask you a second.
That's right.
How many gun murders were there in Britain?
How many great white sharks? No,
how many
kill people
murders
every year, but they're scared to swim?
Right. How many gun murders were there in Britain?
A very low amount. I already went over those
how
statistics.
Many, do you know?
I was only a few hundred.
No. How many gun murders?
I actually did pull up the statistics. Here, let me pull them out right here. I figured you'd do that.
Gun murders
in
Britain last
year. UK violent crime, capital of Europe. London Telegraph. Here, let me give you more.
It's quite a simple question.
Well, that's the oldest.
You're a very loud
man. That's the oldest Perry Mason tactic to ask me some little factoid.
It's not a little factoid.
I already said earlier,
we're talking about
England has a lot lower gun crime rate because you took all the guns.
Let me try exactly my point.
But you've got hordes of people burning down cities and beating old women's brains out every day.
What a ridiculous
thing. They arrest people in England if they defend themselves. That's on record. My God, you've got a total police state. Everybody's fleeing that country because you've had to flee here, bud. Why don't you tell folks? Yeah, you fled here. Why don't you go back and face the charges for the hacking scandal?
Answer this question. How many guns?
Why'd you get fired from the Daily Mirror for putting out fake stories? You're a hatchet man of the New World Order. Okay. You're a hatchet man. And I want to say this right here. You think you're a tough guy? Head me back with a boxing ring in here, and I'll wear red, white, and blue, and you can wear your Jolly Roger.
Okay.
You know what?
Let's try again. How many gun murders were there?
Oh, you're going to ban your fist now?
In Britain last year.
How many chimpanzees can dance on the head of a pin? I already went over those statistics.
Do you know the answer?
No, I don't.
You said hundreds.
It's very low.
You said hundreds.
Yes.
It's actually 35.
Well, the point is you can...
Against 11,000. Do you understand the difference between 11,000
and 35? Yeah, England wants
35.
To ban knives now because tens of thousands are getting stabbed.
But do you understand the difference?
The knife doesn't kill people.
Do you understand?
The gun doesn't kill people.
Yes.
Listen, do you understand
between 35
you're not going to pull on America's heartstrings? They know your script, okay? You're not going to get our guns. By the way, you guys always say, we just want to take the semi-autos, okay, and all this other stuff. When semi-autos aren't even, rifles aren't even used, but in a fraction of the crimes, you can pull those numbers up, okay? Hold on.
Let me ask you one question. Which weapon was predominantly used in the Aurora movie theater shooting?
M4 AR-15 variant.
So it was a semi-automatic assault rifle.
Again.
Okay.
But statistically,
next,
it's very, very low.
That was. Do you agree it was the single biggest shooting in the history of America in terms of people hit by a shooter? Do you know that?
No, I believe that there were others. There's been some other shootings, about over 30.
No. This was the single biggest mass shooting.
Well, listen, you're just there have been bombings of Wall Street.
Let me ask you a second question.
Why can't the pilots have firearms? We trust them to fly the planes.
Alex, you've had a lot to say.
No, just my point is the Second Amendment is sacrosanct, and you're not getting it.
Do you know which weapon was used in the Oregon shopping mall mass shooting recently?
I understand that people... who are mentally ill on all the serotonin reuptake inhibitors, who play these shoot-em-up games, want to go out and do this.
Alex.
Because there's criminals, I don't lose my rights, Piers. Because there's criminals, I don't lose my rights.
Just answer the question.
Yeah.
Do you know what the weapon used was?
Listen, let me ask you a question.
No, answer.
I've got the FBI statistics that, the so-called semi-autos that you talk
about.
Let's
take a break. When we come back.
Again, you're not going to get our guns.
When we come back, try and answer my question.
Yeah, all you're going to do is sit there and play little factoid questions. Overall crime has gone up over 20%. Morgan?
Here's how this is going to work, and it's entirely down to you. I'm going to ask you some questions. In the spirit of a proper debate, and you've had a lot to say so far on the show, a lot of it aimed at me, which is fine, but I want you to try and answer the questions. It's a proper debate, okay? I'm not trying to trip you up.
No, it's not a debate. You're running the show. You bring in your victims up front.
Actually, no.
Look, you got your little note cards.
Okay.
I just gave you FBI statistics that violent crime and gun crime is down over
20%. Alex, let me just ask you
And you want to go to little factoids.
No, they're not little
Anybody can pull those up. Listen.
Do you know what...
you have a bodyguard?
Alex.
Why do you have bodyguards?
I don't have a bodyguard.
Yeah, I've seen you on the news with them.
Don't
you want to protect your wife from hoodlums or you want to call the police?
Let me ask you this question.
Why does Dianne Feinstein tell 60 Minutes... that she plans to try to take Mr. and Mrs. America's guns.
Stop
have you seen
talking
that
over me.
You
let
guys
me...
want to disarm all of America.
No, I don't.
Dianne Feinstein's bill does.
I don't.
Gun confiscation.
No, let me clarify for you. You don't seem to understand
First
what
you register, then you confiscate.
No.
Always done the same.
Here's what the campaign on this
Well, here, give me your little cue cards and I'll answer your questions for
what
you.
What was the weapon used at Sandy Hook?
I've already gone over that and already answered it for
we
you.
We haven't talked about Sandy Hook.
No, again.
What was the weapon?
It's a 223 M4.
Pete Williams, our Chief Justice correspondent, has got some new information as well. Pete, good morning.
Matt, good morning to you. This continues to be a very complex investigation, and there's a lot of contradictory information out there, but there is some new information this morning from a couple of federal officials and state officials. They say now that there were actually four handguns recovered inside the school, not just two, as we were initially told. Four handguns, and apparently only handguns, that were taken into the school. We knew that Adam Lanza, the man said to be the gunman here, also had an assault-style, AR-15-style rifle that he had taken to the school that was in the car he drove there, his mother's car. But we've been told by several officials that he left that in the car. We're also told that on the 11th of December, on Tuesday of this week, Adam Lanza went to a sporting goods store in Danbury, Connecticut, and tried to buy another rifle, but was denied the ability to buy the rifle for a couple of reasons. One is that Connecticut is among the states with stricter gun regulations, and there's a waiting period, so he was denied the rifle for that. And finally, and this may be the most telling piece of information, on the 13th of December, there was, and this, we've been told this by a couple of officials, there was some kind of altercation. He went to the school, got in an argument with four staff members, and we're still trying to determine what the nature of that is.
Right. Again, but statistically, they're using very low percentage of shootings,
but
period.
Are you seeing
people wouldn't go swimming because the movie Jaws, even though great white sharks kill five people a year.
Alex,
you're trying to scare people.
Let me say something.
There's no metal shark in the water.
The same type of weapon was used in the last three mass shootings.
And Hitler used semi-autos to kill people.
Why would you
and
not?
And so did Mao.
Why would you?
Why is the government arming to the teeth against us?
Alex, I don't
What about Fast and Furious?
Alex,
why do our government ship guns into Mexico?
Alex,
to blame the Second Amendment?
Let's have a debate.
A false flag?
Alex.
To blame the Second Amendment?
I get accused.
Why'd they blow up Building 7 down the street here in New York?
I get accused when I get you guys on of talking over you, of being rude. I'm trying to be civil.
Yeah.
Right? You've got to try and answer some of the questions, right? Here's my issue for you. Why do people need, civilians, need an AR-15 type assault rifle? Why
I already said statistically they're used in a very low amount of the crimes. That's an FBI fact.
They've been used in the last three mass shootings.
Yes.
Why?
I'll tell you why.
Them?
Because they advertise it in the media. Anybody knows that if somebody jumps off the Empire State Building, they put cops up there the next day because copycats come to do it again. The media hypes and hypes and hypes.
And that's not the question.
Don't just commit suicide.
Alex, why do people
Don't commit
them?
Suicide by killing a bunch of kids. And here's the gun to use because it's the one the U.S. Army uses.
Why do people need them?
They need them to protect us from the number one killer in history. Government in the 20th century, university study out of Hawaii killed 292 million people. It's called democide. Google it, folks.
Do you believe everyone in America? Should everyone in America, have an AR-15 if they want one?
Statistically, where there's more guns, there's lower crime. The highest crime is in Bloomberg, you know,
But you have the most guns areas. Of any of the 23 richest countries in the world, and you have 11,000
Well, America was born
gun
on guns and whiskey.
Right.
But it's true we're a violent society.
Right.
But statistically,
has the most
knives
guns
kill three
most
times more. Have you seen the FBI numbers? Knives, bats, rocks
assault guns.
kill many
let's
times
talk,
more.
Alex, let's talk it's about
not
the guns.
It's not the rock. It's not the knife. When a mother chops her kids up with a cleaver because she's on serotonin.
Alex, tell me why I'm wrong.
Why don't you want to get rid of the drugs? Because they're half your sponsors.
Then stick to the subject.
America's number one cause of unnatural death now is suicide.
Okay. Alex,
not automobile accident, not cancer, not...
You accuse me of attacking the Second Amendment of the Constitution.
I want to get people off pills that the insert says will make you commit suicide and kill people.
Alex. Let's get about to the second.
I want to blame the real culprit.
Alex.
Suicide pills.
Alex.
Mass murder pills.
Okay, let me ask you one question. Your belief, unless I'm wrong.
First time anybody's ever heard this, by the way.
Your belief, unless I'm wrong, is that under the Second Amendment, your real concern is that you will be overrun by a tyrannical regime.
What happens when self-defense is against the law? What happens when the protectors become the predators? What happens when innocents are betrayed? Imagine that two-thirds of all Americans disappear. 170 million people. Or that the countries of Germany, France, and Spain are virtually wiped off the map. 170 million people gone. In the 20th century, that's how many innocents were slaughtered, tortured, starved, mutilated, worked to death, bayoneted, hanged, annihilated at the hands of their governments. They had no means to defend themselves.
Either from somewhere else?
Yeah, highway checkpoints. Look at Mexico. Total gun ban for the citizens. Highest crime rate in the world. 57,000 people dead the last 5 years. Total gun ban for the citizens.
But you'll make
Switzerland has the lowest crime rate in Europe.
Alex,
your country has the highest.
Alex, we have 35 gun murders a year of 11,000.
People get their brains. It's the higher crime rate.
Let me ask
violent crime is higher.
On this specific.
It's brains.
Alex,
it's people.
I'm trying to get inside your brains.
Pierce, if you punched me right now, it'd be not your fist, but your brain that did
it. Let me get inside your brain.
Okay.
I'm serious. You have a very, very big platform. You air, I think, on 63 networks.
No. That Wikipedia is like 10 years old. I'm on over 140 stations. XM.
Millions of Americans hear you.
Over a million and a half
day.
Visitors to Infowars.com.
And
today,
I congratulate
where we have
you
the statistics posted right now.
Okay.
Infowars.com.
Who do you believe was behind 9/11?
Oh, I absolutely know. I have the police on CNN saying, get back, they're going to blow up 7. I have BBC reporting.
Who do you believe is behind
I have the proof. I heard them on CBS
who?
Radio.
Who, Alex?
They announced they blew up the towers on CBS Radio.
Who do you believe?
New Yorkers all saw it and heard it.
Alex, who do you
they
believe?
They blew up Building 7. Alex. The owner, Larry Silverstein, of the entire complex, got on TV and said that they had blown up Building 7. He said they pulled it, demolition. Well, Silverstein owned them all.
Oh, Silverstein owned all the buildings.
Yeah.
How many buildings are gone?
All of them.
How many is that?
That's right. That plane wasn't that building wasn't hit by a plane.
9 buildings are gone.
Yeah.
Thousands of people lost
that building.
Hundreds more. No.
And there's an official U.S. government plan to carry out the attacks.
He imploded that building on himself.
He admitted it. He said it on television.
He brought that building out.
Yes. Larry Silverstein.
So you understand?
Larry Silverstein on America Rebuilding on PBS said that they blew up Building 7.
They blew up 7. Even
right.
though.
Hey, yeah. He saw it. Did you see it on PBS?
Yeah, he pulled it.
He said on PBS, he said, we pulled the building. PBS.
Oh, yeah, he pulled the building.
Pelted by debris when the North Tower collapsed, 7 burned until late afternoon, allowing occupants to evacuate to safety.
I remember getting a call from the fire department commander telling me that they were not sure they were going to be able to contain the fire. And I said, you know, we've had such terrible loss of life. Maybe the smartest thing to do is pull it. And they made that decision to pull, and then we watched the building collapse.
Yeah, he said we're going to pull. He said we're going to pull the building. Silverstein said we're going
to
pull the building.
And we got the firemen saying they pulled it. I mean, Silverstein goes on PBS and says it, and we're the weirdos when he says it on TV. Unbelievable. Let's see that one more time.
Maybe the smartest thing to do is pull it. And they made that decision to pull, and then we watched the building collapse.
It takes demolition experts weeks to prepare for the destruction of a building. How do they do it on 9/11 in just a few hours?
Who do you believe was behind it? The American government?
Criminal elements of the military-industrial complex, the same ones that staged Gulf of Tonkin, the same ones that staged Operation, the mass shootings of Operation Gladio.
Right.
Ooh, the CIA don't like this right now.
Do you mean that President Bush and his administration were behind 9/11?
I mean that even mainstream news reported that the hijackers were ordered to be allowed into the United States. Michael Springman, the head of the Visa Department, blew the whistle on that.
So the Bush administration was part of a conspiracy.
Well, he
murder,
said never let us tolerate
to murder
Americans. I can speak in this accent as
never
murder.
Yeah.
The government Hitler firebombed his own Reichstag to bring in martial law in Germany.
Malicious lies that attempt to shift the blame away from the terrorists themselves.
Governments have staged terror attacks throughout history, or allowed terrorists to attack as a pretext to invade and enslave the populations. I probably own more than 50 firearms. Many of them have increased in value 2, 3, or even 4 times. I sleep very comfortably outside Austin, Texas, knowing that I can defend my family.
Okay, Alex Jones. This is
Infowars.com.
This is the man who wants to deport me from the country for wanting to get rid of
assault rifles. It's to point out you're a foreigner, a red coat, here telling us what to do.
Whatever.
Go back to where they took the guns if you don't like it. The communists.
Alan Dershowitz, who's agreed to defend me from deportation. Very kind of you. I think you defended John Lennon, no less. Interesting encounter there with Alex Jones. He's the guy behind this petition to have me deported. He's really one of the reasons why I'm so concerned about the lack of gun control in America. He's a man that owns 50 weapons. He has a sort of pathological view about it. He seems unhinged to me. The irony of these gun rights guys saying to me that I'm rude to them won't be lost on my regular viewers, I'm sure.
Your murder rate is lower than ours. That is true.
Lower? Your it's violent 35 against 12,000.
Your violent crime rate.
They had a
your
massacre,
violent crime rate is higher than
weapons.
Ours, as is the violent crime rate in Australia. America is not the Wild West that you are depicting. We only have the problem in our cities and unhappily in our schools, where people like you have been able to get laws put on the books that keep people from being able to defend themselves. I honestly don't understand why you would rather have people be victims of a crime than be able to defend themselves. It's incomprehensible.
You're an unbelievably stupid man, aren't you?
It seems to me that you're morally obtuse. You seem to prefer being a victim to being able to prevail over the criminal element. And I don't know why you want to be the criminal's friend.
I try to stay calm. And really, there's no other way of dealing with him, because he's just a sort of ranting guy who doesn't want anybody to grab his guns, but no sense of awareness about the wider issue of a particular type of weapon mm-hmm. being used to commit these mass outrages.
Well, we lawyers refer to people like that not as witnesses, but as exhibits. Mm. He was an exhibit, like a piece of evidence. You just see him speaking, and you say to yourself, I don't want that man to have a gun. I wouldn't feel comfortable having an argument with him in his home where he had access to his 50 weapons. And if he got really mad at something I said, or if I disputed his contentions, or I told him he was lying about the FBI statistics and that he was lying about the claim more guns equal less crime, I would be worried he would grab for his semi-automatic and try to resolve it.
What really would concern me about somebody like him is the amount of influence he has, a growing influence, as he boasted. He's got millions of people mm-hmm. listening to him. Some of his YouTube rants have got tens of mm-hmm. millions of people watching them. And he foments this fear of a tyrannical regime, and that is why everyone in America needs to be armed with AR-15s. And it's the stuff of nonsense, isn't it?
I mean, well, it's much more dangerous than nonsense. I mean, he was essentially comparing President Bush to Adolf Hitler.
Yeah.
He was saying that somebody, the criminal elements within our banks, the Bloombergs, the national banks.
But here's the point, yeah. You can't dismiss him as just a crackpot, because millions of Americans tune into him now on a daily basis and believe what he
but
says.
Let me tell you,
that is why, to me, he's a very relevant guest here, and he perfectly exemplifies the problem.
But the reason you perform such a great service by having him on is he usually preaches to his own little paranoid choir. Mm. People who listen to him are either listening to him for entertainment purposes, the way I sometimes listen to Rush Limbaugh, or because they really believe it. Now, you expose
well, we have a little exchange, actually.
To a general audience.
This is a little exchange that happened just right at the end here, mm-hmm. which others haven't seen yet.
And I'm here to tell you, 1776 will commence again if you try to take our firearms. Doesn't matter how many lemmings you get out there on the street begging for them to have their guns taken. We will not relinquish them. Do you understand? That's why you're going to fail, and the establishment knows, no matter how much propaganda, the Republic will rise again when you attempt to take our guns.
Aaron Dykes here for InfoWars.com. This gun control debate is reaching dangerous proportions. Last night, Alex Jones debated Piers Morgan on CNN. Tonight, all they can do is talk about the reaction, and on Piers Morgan's program, they talk about they hope Alex's children don't die. Now, Alex was sitting at home with his family and children. They were freaked out and terrorized by those comments, but the program went on to even more outrageous points. Buzz Bissinger, a sports columnist for the Daily Beast, chimed in and said that he thinks the only reason for a semi-automatic weapon is so that Piers Morgan can go in the ring and, quote, pop Alex Jones with that weapon. And then all the guests go on to laugh about it.
I don't care what the justification is that you're allowed in this country to own a semi-automatic weapon, much less a handgun. But what do you need a semi-automatic weapon for? The only reason I think you need it is, Piers, challenge Alex Jones to a boxing match, show up with a semi-automatic that you got legally, and pop him.
I'd love to see that. In uniform.
I'll borrow my brother's uniform.
Now, without a doubt, this was a veiled threat. But just imagine if Alex Jones or anyone else made these comments, they'd be arrested immediately, and yet here they are saying them with impunity. Remember, there's been threats against NRA board members, you name it, in the past. These authoritarians don't want peace. They want control. And they're showing it here. Get this out immediately. Signing off for InfoWars.com.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have had 2 hours sleep on the plane. Got up at about 4 this morning, took about a 30-minute nap in the hotel room, got up at 4 because I was working through the night filing videos, and then got on the plane, maybe slept an hour and a half, so a total of about 2 hours. So bear with me today. Our plane landed about 35 minutes ago at Austin-Bergstrom International Airport. It is the 8th day of January, 2013. I am your host, Alex Jones. And quite frankly, I never thought they'd even put me on CNN because they know live on air I would basically run over them. You notice I didn't even wear a sports jacket or a tie or anything like that because I don't respect that show. It's got 500,000 viewers on average. Today and yesterday, it's the number one Twitter term in the country, Alex Jones. And a lot of that is because of our radio listeners, but also DrudgeReport.com pushing the story and really being there to help, you know, show our side of what's happening. I walked in here, I don't know, 10 minutes ago, literally, and I was back in the coffee room trying to get some coffee and wake up here. I'm wearing the same shirt I was wearing last night on Piers Morgan, and that's how much I've been moving here. And he was on CNN playing a clip from earlier. It's wall to wall. Tonight is about the Alex Jones fallout. And of course, they don't want to hear from me. And they're attacking the First Amendment. In fact, I mean, I heard it bigger than Dallas. McBreen says it's been on all day long, where they're saying this man has too big a platform. So see, they're going from saying I don't exist to saying we have too big a platform. Because imagine, let me explain something. I've been at CNN 10 years ago in New York. I was in CNN about 6 years ago in New York. I was in CNN 2 years ago in New York. The same place, same studios. That place looks like a bombed out World War I. No, scratch that. It looks like Hitler's bunker. And I thought maybe they just put me in a, it was in a studio green room with Fareed Zarkaria's picture on the wall. And I thought, well, maybe this is just so torn up carpet, feces all over the toilet and the floor of the bathroom. I thought, well, maybe this is just this green room. So I went into the green room that had the Kennedys in it right before they arrived, some Kennedys pitching a book. And it was rotting. And let me tell you something, folks. New York City is a giant tomb. When this country goes into full depression, you do not want to be in there. I mean, I was at a restaurant, not even that fancy, last night, getting some dinner after we got off the plane. You know, I got up at 5 a.m. yesterday. I'm not bragging, hey, I haven't slept. The reason I look like hell is, folks, I'm a race car that doesn't do pit stops. I mean, I am just pushing it as hard as I can. And I ordered not even something very expensive off the menu. And there were people watching when we were eating, watching what others were eating. Everyone was talking about money around me. And this is in Midtown Manhattan, one of the wealthier areas. This country's just in deep trouble. And Mayor Bloomberg is going to bankrupt all those people to put them in coffin size for the coffin city. Once a great American city, the Big Apple is now a rose-colored, apple-colored coffin. And they have these little 250-square-foot rooms where they're going to charge you so much tax, you and your whole family are going to live in that. While he lives in a giant, you know, mansion, penthouse with just festooned with armaments and guards with weapons everywhere, and he takes off the roof in his fleet of helicopters. And he's even bought a tilt-wing aircraft. They have a smaller Osprey. And I'm not against someone having money. He just got it all from inside deals on the stock market. But and we had, you know, like, it's like, really? There's like detective goons following us around and bugging their eyes out at us and then coming up and saying that, I mean, it was just unbelievable. And now Piers Morgan's talking about trying to get rid of my First Amendment rights. They want the guns. They want us disarmed.
when you have this debate on the East Coast or even the West Coast, I find that a lot of Americans come up to me and they're totally behind what I'm trying to do, which is a very specific thing. It's not about taking away his right to defend himself or his family at home or to grab anybody's guns other than these military-style assault weapons. But he doesn't want to hear any of the nuances of the debate. He couldn't tell me how many people get murdered by guns.
Because he doesn't want to hear the other side of the
story. Answer. He knows it's very, very low. He doesn't want to hear it.
And one thing I would suggest is it's time for us, you know, everybody hates commissions, but it's time for us to have a commission of 10 great distinguished scientists to put the lie to this notion that more guns, less crime. I know the statistics. I know the FBI data. I teach it. But most Americans believe the NRA propaganda. The NRA buys scholars.
And it's
they
total,
buy statistics.
It's,
and it's just wrong.
Lies.
It's total lies.
It is total lies. Britain has strong gun control, for example, and averages 35 gun murders a year. America has very lax gun control and has 11,000. Britain is about a fifth of the size of America. I can do simple math. Japan has the toughest gun control in the world. They have two or three murders a year. Australia had a massacre in the 90s. They brought in a ban on all main high-powered guns and assault rifles and so on. They've had no mass shooting since.
A 15-year-old at home with his 12-year-old sister when burglars try to break in.
That's when investigators say the boy grabbed his dad's assault rifle and started shooting, and he hit one of the men repeatedly. This all unfolded this afternoon in the 2600 block of Royal Place Court. 11 News reporter Sharon Min Chow talked with neighbors and investigators.
Anxious family and friends cross the yellow tape into a surreal crime scene. A 15-year-old boy and his 12-year-old sister had been home alone in the Mount Royal Village subdivision. Then about 2:30, a pair of home invaders tried the front and back doors, then broke a back window.
A young boy was protecting his sister. You know, he was in fear for his life and for his sister's life.
The brother grabbed his father's assault rifle and knew what to do with it. His dad is a Precinct 1 deputy constable.
We don't try to hide things from our children in law enforcement.
The children were not hurt. The home invaders fled, leaving a trail of blood.
Two suspects showed up at Tomball Hospital. One, the adult, had multiple gunshot wounds and was flown to Memorial Hermann Hospital. The second, a juvenile, was taken back here.
Detectives walked the suspect through the crime scene. Meantime, neighbors say burglars had recently struck the two houses next door, which included the deputy's home.
They stole everything what they have inside. They really did it one time.
And this may be the last time, at least for these suspects. In Northwest Harris County, Sharon Min Chow, 11 News.
This is not rocket science. It is there to be had. The problem is that the NRA, and I'm sure that Mr. Jones is a big fan of theirs and probably helps them.
Oh, he probably thinks they're way, way, way too much part of the establishment.
Right,
he's way too
the right
of
this country
the NRA.
Is the political power the NRA now wield means that politicians are too coward to say anything. I mean, I have people say to me, you're so brave. What is brave about wanting to stop 20 more children getting murdered?
I don't think you're right about that. I don't think it's the NRA power. I think it's people like us, and not the two of us, but Americans who care about guns aren't doing enough to make our case to the public.
But why not?
Because we think it's their issue. We've given that issue over to them because they have lobbyists, they pay money. But in the end, the people determine the
on guns. My next guest has strong words for me. He says, I'm off the rails on guns in America. Ben Shapiro is editor-at-large at Breitbart.com and the author of Bullies, How a Less Culture of Fear and Intimidation Silences Americans. So why am I off the rails, Mr. Shapiro?
You know, honestly, Pierce, you've kind of been a bully on this issue because what you do, and I've seen it repeatedly on your show, I watch your show, and I've seen it repeatedly, what you tend to do is you tend to demonize people who differ from you politically by standing on the graves of the children of Sandy Hook, saying they don't seem to care enough about the dead kids. If they cared more about the dead kids, they would agree with you on policy. I think we can have a rational political conversation about balancing rights and risks and rewards of all of these different policies, but I don't think that what we need to do is demonize people on the other side as being unfeeling about the about what happened in Sandy Hook.
How dare you accuse me of standing on the graves of the children that died there? How dare you?
I've seen you do it repeatedly, Pierce.
Like I say, how dare you?
Well, I mean, you can keep saying that, but you've done it repeatedly. What you do, and I've seen you do it on the program, is you keep saying to folks that if they disagree with you politically, then somehow this is a violation of what happened in Sandy Hook. And you have yet, I'd really like to hear your policy prescriptions for what we should do about guns. Because you say that you respect the Second Amendment, and, you know, I brought this here for you so that you can read it. It's the Constitution. And I would really like for you to explain to me what you would do about guns that would have prevented what happened in Sandy Hook. If you want to do what you did in the UK, right, which is ban virtually all guns, that is at least a fair argument. And we can have a discussion about whether that's something that we ought to do
or not. Well, I made it very clear what I want to do, which is exactly what Mark Kelly wants to do. And in fact, rather than address rather than address your comments to me about standing on the graves of children at Sandy Hook, you can address them to Mark Kelly, because he agrees with everything that I've been saying, because he feels the same way as does his wife. They're gun owners. They both respect the Second Amendment of the Constitution. They don't want to take away anybody's right to defend themselves with guns.
They want to take away certain types of guns, obviously.
They want to take away assault weapons, which are capable, with magazines like we saw at Aurora and Sandy Hook, of unleashing a ridiculous amount of bullets.
Well, this is a question I wanted to ask you, Piers, because I've seen you talk about assault weapons a lot, and I've seen Mark Kelly talk about assault weapons. Mm. The vast majority of murders in this country that are committed with guns are not committed with assault weapons, they're committed with handguns. Okay, so are you willing to ban handguns in this country across the country?
No, that's not what I'm asking for.
Why not?
Let me ask you.
Don't you care about the kids who are being killed in Chicago as much as the kids in Sandy Hook?
Yes, I do.
Then why don't you care about banning the handguns in Chicago?
We'll come to that. Let me ask you this. What was the weapon used at Aurora in the movie theater?
It was an assault rifle, sure.
Okay. What was the weapon used in the Oregon shopping mall?
I believe it was an assault rifle, correct?
Okay. What was the weapon used at Sandy Hook?
It was an assault rifle.
What was the weapon used at the incident around Christmas when the firemen were lured to their deaths in New York State Fire?
And bought illegally? That was an assault rifle.
Right. So the last four mass shootings in America were all the assault rifles.
And the vast
that is the reason, Mr. Shapiro. And you can smirk at me, and you can laugh at me.
I'm not smirking.
And you can accuse me of standing on the graves of dead children.
And being a bully, yes.
But that is the reason that people like me and Mark Kelly and Gabrielle Giffords want to have assault weapons like that removed from civilian hands.
Your passion on the issue doesn't really justify the rationale for why you want to ban assault weapons, but not handguns.
You don't understand why we want to remove the preferred weapon of choice, these killing machines, from the hands of deranged young men.
All I'm asking is for you to be philosophically consistent. If what you're worried about is the removal of killing machines from the hands of deranged young people, then maybe we should talk about a blanket gun ban. And let's get to what the left really wants here. And you say that you're for the Second Amendment.
Why is it about left or right? Because in Britain, this never is about left or right, this issue. Why is it here?
Well, we can talk about Britain in a second. I think the reason that it's about left and right here is because, fundamentally, the right believes that the basis for the Second Amendment, and they believe in the Second Amendment, the basis for the Second Amendment is not really about self-defense, and it's not about hunting. It is about resistance to government tyranny. That's what the founders said, and that's what the right believes in this country.
Which tyranny are you fearing yourself?
I fear the possibility of a tyranny rising in this country in the next 50 to 100 years. Let me tell you something, Piers. The fact that my grandparents and great-grandparents in Europe didn't fear that is why they're now ashes in Europe. So this kind of leftist revisionist history, where there's never any fear of democracy going usurpacious or tyrannical, is just that.
It's fictitious. Just to clarify your position then, the answer to Sandy Hook, as it was to Aurora, as it was to Gabrielle Giffords, as it was to Columbine, Virginia Tech, is you do nothing. Is that your position?
And that's not my position. My position is that we have to calibrate laws that are designed to get guns out of the hands of bad people, and keep guns in the hands of good people who want to buy them. This idea of more guns versus less guns.
How do you do that?
Well, I think one of the ways that you do that is by better screening for mental illness. I think that you do better background checks.
Was Adam Lanza's mother a good person?
I don't know whether she was a good person or a bad person. I know she was irresponsible with her guns.
Has there been any evidence to suggest she was not a good person?
No, but there's been significant evidence.
So by your criteria, wait a minute. By your criteria of the good people should be allowed the guns and the bad people shouldn't, she would have been allowed the guns.
She was an irresponsible person. She didn't keep her guns locked up. And that should be against the law. If you have a mentally ill person in your house, we're talking about laws that we can both agree on here. I don't know why you're disagreeing with me on this.
Then she becomes a bad person, does she?
Well, no, it's not a matter of morally good versus morally bad.
You set the criteria, good and bad. So is she good or bad?
You're right, Piers. I should have said responsible versus irresponsible. Mm. That's correct.
Okay, so she goes from good to bad.
No, she goes from responsible to irresponsible. Mm-hmm.
Let's take a break. Let's come back and talk more about this, because we don't agree. My name is Ben Shapiro, editor-at-large at Brightbar.com and the author of Bullies. Do you believe that if you had an assault weapon ban, statistics prove that you could dry up the supply of these guns and make them less accessible to criminals?
I don't know whether you could make them less accessible to criminals. Let's assume that's the case, that you could make them less accessible to criminals. Again, my question remains for you, Piers, and I'm still waiting for an answer from the left on this. Mm. They say they're pro-Second Amendment. Why don't you want to ban handguns? If you really want to solve the quote-unquote gun violence problem in America, go after all the guns. Why just stop yourself at assault rifles?
Because I believe and respect an American's right under the Second Amendment of the Constitution that you kindly brought in to defend themselves with a handgun or a pistol. What I don't understand...
But most of the murders are committed with those weapons.
What I don't... Well, as we just established, as I talked you through them, the last four mass shootings in America...
Adam Lanza had two pistols on him. Well, he didn't just have an assault rifle. If he hadn't had the assault rifle...
He didn't use them, as you know.
And if he hadn't had the assault rifle, he wouldn't have used them?
Explain to me this. I can't buy this. This is six packets of Sudafed. They're one of the many companies that make this particular ingredient, which you can't buy legally in America. There we are, six packets. That is illegal for me to buy in that quantity in Walmart, say. Mm-hmm. But I can buy an AR-15 military-style assault rifle. I can then, as we saw with Holmes, the shooter in Aurora, go and get 6,000 rounds of ammunition from the internet, and I can go and blow up a movie theater. Do you think that's right?
Well, we can talk drug laws another time, but no, I think
does that make sense to you?
No, I think what would make sense is laws that are calibrated to solve the problem. Mm-hmm. So if you think that the problem is only assault rifles...
Which guns would you remove?
I think the ones that have largely been removed from the market, fully automatic weapons, would be a good start. Mm-hmm. I think that...
You wouldn't remove any semi-automatics at all?
No, because semi-automatic just means that when you pull the trigger once, one bullet comes out.
Do you understand how an AR-15 performs when it's been modified and has a magazine with 100 bullets?
I saw it in the North Hollywood shootout. You know what? It was illegal to do that, and people did it anyway. Mm. We have 12 million illegal immigrants in this country. We're not able to stop people from coming illegally into this country over the southern border into places like California, where I live normally. I think you'd be very hard-pressed to stop guns from coming across that border illegally as well. I mean, right. California has some of the strictest gun laws in the
nation. Would you want every American to have an AR-15?
No, not every American.
Who would you stop?
I would stop anyone with a criminal background. Mm-hmm. I would stop anybody with a history of mental illness. Mm-hmm. And I would require that people who have somebody who has a criminal background or a history of mental illness in the household mm-hmm. keep that gun locked up and safe.
What about the background checks? 40% of all gun sales in America now, gun trades, are not covered by background checks.
I believe in background checks.
For everybody?
For everybody.
So there should be a database, a national register?
If it's not public. I don't like what happened with the Journal News putting out gun permits, which allows criminals to target particular homes.
When the NRA came out today after their meeting with the White House and just said we're just not prepared to entertain effectively any kind of new gun restrictions, what do you think of that?
What's astonishing to me is the left's attack on the NRA, because the NRA is, they don't receive a dime of public dollars. They're an interest group. I don't see, it's funny, the left, they like to talk also about violent video games,
for
example.
Can you stop framing it as left or right? Because sure. I don't have a horse in the race. I'm going to vote either way.
Come on, Piers. You tend to be more to the left. Right. We all understand
the NRA, as you know, are a very active and well-funded and powerful body. And what they do...
Why are you asking? This is very quick, I promise. The point that I'm making is this. There's been a lot of talk by a lot of people about video game violence. I haven't seen David Gregory interviewing the head of the ACLU and saying it's your broad interpretation of the First Amendment that's responsible for this. But people are bringing on the NRA and saying it's your broad interpretation of the Second Amendment that's responsible for this. Mm. They're an interest group. If you want legislation passed, right. Talk to legislators. Don't go to the NRA, which is representing its membership.
Here's what the NRA and people like Alex Jones and others do.
Don't let me in with Alex Jones.
Fine. After each of these massacres, they come out. All the gun rights supporters come out very strongly and very vociferous and very powerful. And they basically instill fear. They say if everyone in the movie theater had been armed, if everyone at the school had been armed, it wouldn't have happened. And here's what happens. Gun sales and ammunition sales rocket, as we've seen in the last 3 weeks.
Oh, don't pass the buck, Piers. I mean, the truth is that the reason that people are buying a lot of guns right now, Piers, is because people on the left are talking very much about banning guns. And so a lot of people are saying, if I'm not going to have the right to purchase a weapon of my choosing in 2 months, I'm going to go and buy it now. This is very clearly
what's
going on.
Why did Ronald Reagan want these assault weapons removed?
I don't know why Ronald Reagan wanted these assault weapons
removed. You like Reagan, right?
I like Reagan in a lot of ways. He's not a god. I don't agree with him on everything.
Did you agree with him?
He also believed in the
weapons?
Progressive tax rate. I don't believe in that.
Did you agree with him about assault weapons?
I'll believe what you're saying. Sure. I don't know what his position on assault weapons was.
Let me read the letter in full. This was a letter that he penned along with Presidents Ford and Carter in 1994 to Congress. While we recognize that assault weapon legislation will not stop all assault weapon crime, statistics prove that we can dry up the supply of these guns, making them less accessible to criminals. We urge you to listen to the American public and to the law enforcement community in support of ban on the further manufacture of these weapons. That was Ronald Reagan.
Okay, so. I mean, I can disagree with Ronald Reagan.
You keep framing this as a left-right debate. I'm putting it to you.
How is this a left-right?
One of the great right-wing presidents of modern times agreed with me.
So?
So it's not left or right, is it?
No, I mean, it is.
Unless you deliberately frame it that way.
Okay, Piers.
In the way that the NRA through the 80s and 90s and this last
Piers,
decade
avoiding the breakdown of left and
have
right
deliberately
here
tried
is
to frame this as a left-wing attack on the American Constitution and the Second Amendment, exactly what you've tried to do. You come in, you brandish your little book as if I don't know
my
what's
little
in
book,
there.
That's the Constitution of the United States, our founding document.
I know
Piers.
What's in your Constitution.
Do you really?
I've been debating this for a very long time.
Then you what should I read the Second Amendment again.
I know the Second Amendment. What I haven't heard is one coherent reason why any civilian in America needs an AR-15 military-style assault weapon. Tell me why you need one.
I told you why the general population of America, law-abiding citizens,
why
need an
AR-15. Why do they need those weapons?
They need them for the prospective possibility of resistance to tyranny, which is not a concern today. It may not be a concern tomorrow.
Where are you expecting the tyranny to come from?
It could come from the United States, because governments have gone tyrannical before.
Do you understand how absurd you sound when you say
that? Here's where you go into the absurd and the bullying. You're absurd. You're stupid. I understand that.
I'm not the one that came in here and accused you of standing on the graves of dead children.
Because you're the one who's doing that.
Bullying.
Punching back twice as hard. You know what I call it? Punching back twice as hard in the words of President Obama.
That's what I call bullying.
Oh, this is astonishing.
What's astonishing?
What's astonishing about it is that for weeks now, you have been saying that anybody who disagrees with your position is absurd, idiotic, and doesn't care about the dead kids in Sandy Hook. And then when I say that that's a bully tactic, you turn around and say, I'm bullying you for saying that. It's absurd. It's ridiculous.
Let me ask you again. What is the point of a civilian having an AR-15 assault weapon?
The point of a civilian having an AR-15 assault weapon, many of them are ex-military, right? I mean, I have military friends, and I have I don't have a problem with Colin Powell owning an AR-15 assault weapon.
And what is the point of a civilian owning them?
It depends on the civilian. If it's a criminal, they shouldn't own them.
No, forget criminals and mentally ill people.
No, but you can't separate that out.
An average civilian
who
hasn't got
civilian.
A criminal record or is mentally ill, why do they need one?
To protect against the possibility of eventual government tyranny. This was the purpose of the Second Amendment originally. It remains the purpose of the Second Amendment now. And pretending that governments have never gone usurpacious before from a
Do you genuinely
position?
Believe your own government is going to turn on you in a way that you require
it may not turn
an
on
AR-15
me.
To challenge them? This is what you really believe
it may
is
not
going to happen
on me. It
in
may not turn on
America.
My children.
Is that what you think?
It may not turn on me. It may not turn on my children. Mm. But the fact is this. History is replete with democracies going tyrannical. Mm. It has happened. It happened in France in the 19th century. It happened in Spain in the last century. Okay. It happened in Germany. It happened in Italy. It has happened repeatedly throughout
history.
It happened in Japan.
The reason we cannot remove AR-15 assault weapons is because the threat of your own government turning on you in a tyrannical way.
It is because there are countervailing rights and responsibilities. And I don't understand why we can't
position.
Come to it. Why can't we come
you
to agree about reasonable
you,
law?
Because
you just
want
to demagogue the issue.
You have made your point crystal clear. People aren't stupid. They can make up their own minds.